Now we will discuss how to study. So I'm going to break this part into three sections. First is your active learning. Second would be your active revision. And third would be your super active Red Bull based last month. So first step of your preparation, which is learning, we will further divide this into three parts or three steps. Step number one, video. Once you are good with the concepts, step number two, we do questions. Okay, now this year we had really, really good results at level two. And one of the things that worked for us is that people followed these steps sincerely. Okay, so I do not recommend reading after you've seen videos or done classes. I recommend directly jumping onto questions, okay, because that kind of helps you build different thinking perspective on the same matter. So which questions are we looking at? Number one is end of the chapter questions, CFA curriculum. So if you are not going to solve them, you're out of the game anyways. So level two, let's say that you are not able to solve end of the chapter questions for four subjects, you're out of the game. There's no point even considering writing the exams, that's not going to work. So this is extremely important, we can't skip this. Step number two, blue boxes. So I don't think many, how many of you did blue, do you know blue boxes? These are the examples which are given in CFA curriculum. How many of you did this at L1? Yeah, good. And then a lot of people will, you know, decide not to do them. A lot of people might find them too in-depth. But the idea is that they kind of dig a level deeper than the end of the chapter questions. Okay, so you have to do them only once. Just go through them once and then use a star mark rating system where you identify which ones you want to see for the next time. And then only revise the difficult ones. Step number three in terms of questions is our weekly test. And weekly test for most of the part is going to be different than the type of questions you would see in the curriculum. Okay, so we try to put in as much variety as much possible so that you get to solve questions from different perspectives and different writing styles. Once you've done this, then step number three is reading the curriculum. So curriculum is what, about 3000, just 3000 odd pages. But having said that, it's extremely wordy. Okay, so it's extremely wordy, plus like a lot of time it happens to me as well. When I'm trying to read something, and especially I'm reading very fast, after some time I forget what was I really trying to read through this, because it kind of keeps on navigating from one concept to another at times. So the idea is that whatever you need to know for the exam, from curriculum, from different notes, everything gets condensed into your classroom notes. Okay, so, or if you're not doing classroom, then everything is a part of the video lectures. So if you can read curriculum, that's a significant advantage. Okay, if you cannot read curriculum, then you can substitute this with whatever classroom notes that you're going to prepare with me here. Now, active revision. Level 2 syllabus is kind of on the extreme end. Okay, there are certain sections which are extremely quantitative in nature. So of course, quant is there. Then we have fixed income towards the end, there is too much of mathematics. Derivatives has too much of mathematics. Even FRA compared to level 1, at level 2 is smaller in size and it is more quantitative and less theory. Okay, so this is more number oriented areas. And on the other extreme, there are certain subjects which are just too much of theory. Okay, so which has alternative investment, which has equity, even corporate finance to a large extent, except the first reading, the theory just keeps on going, and you know, at times it's very frustrating. So even if you do something and if you do not revise that, then your entire preparation is going to go for a toss. So what I'm going to recommend with level 2 is that your revision is more important than doing a new topic. Okay, so if you have, let us say, every day on a weekday you're going to invest 2 hours, so that's 120 minutes, invest at least 20% of that time into your revision on a daily basis. That's what successful candidates did for the last few years. That when they started, for example, you're starting out your studies today. So this is about what time? 7 o'clock, you're going to study till 9. invest the first 20 minutes in revising what you have been doing so far, and invest the most efficient time of yours. So if you think you're good at morning, you're typically good at studies in the morning, then use that time for revision purpose. How are you going to revise? Step number one, we are building this product. We did a soft launch for level one sometime back. These are called commuter notes. These are essentially audio notes, and they'll come in a app format. So we are recording them in a discussion group session or a discussion type of a setup. So there are 3-4 people who are discussing certain concepts. One person is asking questions, the other people are trying to answer. They would come in audio format, and you can carry them whenever you're traveling. So use them when you're traveling from your residence to your office. Okay, or use them when you're maybe working in the kitchen, or maybe use them when you're working in your office. So if that is allowed, but use them whenever you are not able to study actively. What they will do is that they will optimize your time. You know, time that otherwise would have wasted, you can end up revising one entire topic with this. So this could be one handy tool of revision. Second, some of you use this. How many of you use mobile notes? L1. Okay, so we are developing similar mobile notes for L2 as well now. We already have done 60-70% of the part. So these are going to be graphics, fluorescent colors, most of the time handwritten. So put them in your mobile phone and then try to go through them whenever you find time. Third, we've built a study planner. Use of this, I'll show you how to use that. So this is the list of all of your readings. Okay, subject wise categorized. So let us say in the class we are on to financial reporting, and we did a reading called intercorporate investments. So the moment you do that reading for the first time, either it could be in the form of a video or it could be in the form of attending a live classroom session, reading notes, whatever, then you come on this section and you ask yourself that how difficult did I find this reading? Okay, so now the typical observation that we've had, that generally most of the people are really good with corporate finance. I mean, it might have happened to you as well. Whenever you start studying, you would start studying with corporate finance, that too with capital budgeting at level one. And then by the time you reach exams, you're very good with capital budgeting, but you're never good with corporate governance, because that happened to be the last reading. And that's what all of us do. Even I used to do it. I used to always start from the beginning, and the first few topics used to be really good. And then after that, of course, it used to go down. But ideally, you should be studying difficult topic more number of times and easy topic less number of times. So what we've done here is you decide how difficult that topic is for you. Okay. For example, let us say intercorporate investments, you find quite easy. So the moment you choose quite easy, the Excel file will tell you that you should revise this 3 times before you write the final examinations. Okay, because this is the easiest topic for you. So it is okay if you revise less number of times. But if you think that the topic is maybe moderate, then revise more number of times. But if you think that the topic is very difficult, I did not want to use the word difficult, so very good. So if the topic is very good, then you should revise more number of times. So what this will do is it will force you to systematically organize your studies. Study difficult topic more number of times and easy topic less number of times. So you're always focusing on where the efforts are needed. Now, how do you use this section? So once you come in here, you just put in the date. So this is the 3rd September. You can use shortcut control semicolon in Excel. It will hard code the current date. Okay, so 3rd September is the topic when you revise this for the first time. Now the revision cycle that I recommend is day 0, day 1, 14 and 21. Okay, so how do you automate your study? So if you did something on day 0, that was 3rd September, come on to this file, 3rd September plus 1. So the first revision of this topic you should be doing on 4th of September. Then once you come here, this would be 4th September plus 7. So the third revision or second revision, third time studies should be done on 11th September. And then we've done some conditional formatting on this Excel file. So every day in the morning when you open the file, all the topics that you're supposed to revise today, they would be shown in this format. Like today is 3rd September, that's why it is showing a different format. So it will show a black color font with white color. So you open your Excel file in the morning and it will automatically show you which all subjects or readings you are supposed to revise today. So first finish your revision and then start doing new topics. Are we okay with this? And now the last part, which was essentially about your last month. Now, the best strategy here is to have entire 30 days of leave. It will give you reasonable time to revise, if not 21 days. Okay, anything less than that, you're in trouble. Okay, so at minimum, the leave that we're looking at is 21 days. This is the time when we will have 7 full-length mocks. Okay, so the format is similar. Most of you did level 1 here, so you would know how we did things. These are going to be morning 9 to 12 and afternoon 2 to 5. We are going to try to replicate the exam environment. Plus, at level 2, the style of the case study is something that you cannot afford to get used to. If you just get used to the curriculum style of the case study, and on the exam, if the language is different, the style is different, you're going to be in trouble. So in these 7 mocks, we are going to use as many different styles as possible, so that you get acquainted with different ways in which the questions can be written. So you should be writing all the 7 mocks, and then you're all right for the exams.